and sweeps me off my feet. And this is just the fella to do it. Slow down, Sydney. I don't want to speak about yet. I hope you wanted to say first.
I'm sorry, Laura.
I didn't see you there. I thought you'd be down in the practice.
Practice? Oh, dear me, no, I don't need practice anymore. Do you know, last week I gave birth to twins without any trouble at all.
We didn't even know you were expecting.
Not me at all, Mrs. Brown in the village.
You must excuse Sydney.
He's washed his brains. Can't do a thing with them. I know everything about this lad, you know. I delivered him. I had to post them on holiday. And here he is, Sydney, the second son of the late lamented Moses Millstone. How does it feel to be heart over a window, then, my cherub?
I don't know where I am, heart over yet.
How do you mean?
Oh, that remains won't.
Oh, won't? Oh, you must mean a will.
Oh, yes, that's right, a will.
Well, what does a will say?
Nobody knows yet. It's going to be read out in a few minutes. I know from the voice, especially to do it.
Ooh, how exciting! I think I'll stay. We had our ups and downs, you know. But he always had a soft spot for me. I always made sure he got his rheumatism pills on time. And when he had that carbuncle on his posterior, who was it that used to change the dressing?
We're one for turning the other cheek.
You are awful, but I like you.
Any sleeping up yet? There's a lift in due at any minute. Go and fix the basket. It's in the barn on bowling wheat.
Why do I always have to do what you say?
Because I'm the eldest brother, that's why. And besides, if I was to leave the running of the mill to you, we'd go broke in a month.
Don't be angry, Silas. He does try his best.
If that's his best, heaven help his worst. Go on before I get mad. And I suppose you're all here to find out what my father's will says.
Well, we did all know your father very well. We thought he might have remembered us.
But apart from the mill and the family, now there's nothing worth having.
Oh, come now, he must have had a few trinkets stashed away, like your diamond ring or string bells.
Well, if there's anything of any value, it should come to me. I'm the oldest brother, I deserve the lion's share.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, Sebastian.
Were you looking for me, Silas?
Yes, the solicitor is soon to read Father's will. And though no doubt I will be left the majority of his estate, it is only right that you should be there as his youngest son, in case there may be some small something in for you.
I'm not searching for fame or fortune. So long as I have a job and a place to rest my head.
I think that's just as well, because I have a distinct feeling you're going to be out of luck.
We have the sunshine and the flowers. What more can we ask for? Don't you agree, Tom? Well, I hope you're wearing all just his briefs. There's a coffin for these.
Yes, little Getty.
Enough of this frivolity. This is a very serious occasion. Now, you stand over there and take that fleering cat with you. Oh, don't let him get in the way.
Don't upset yourself, Tom. He didn't mean it. He's just gone out, that's all.
Oh, didn't I? I'll tell you all something for free. As soon as the will's read out, there'll be some changes around here. And the first thing to go will be that lousy cat. I found you, Finder. Ah, Mr. Testament, how nice to see you. Did you have a good trip?
Did you, Mr. Millstone? Yes, I've all told you about the gift. May I say how sorry I was to hear of your father's recent demise?
Yes, we all were. It's the little wind that doesn't blow some easily good, isn't it?
Yes, indeed. The senior partner on the phone, testament to Codicil, testament. It's advised you to read the will of the dear departed.
He must be one of the Old Testaments. Why don't you grow up, stupid? Get grown up, stupid. Sorry for that, Mr. Testament. Pray to see you.
I have here the said will, which reads as follows. I, Moses, frankincense, periwinkle millstone, being of sound mind, do leave my estate as follows. To my eldest son, Silas, I bequeath my entire fortune and my flour mill to do with as he pleases.
I knew father had good sense when it came to business matters.
To my second son, Sidney, I bequeath my cow, Clara, in the hope that he may find his true vocation as a dairy farmer, and that the cream he makes turns out to be as thick as he is.
Cowboy!
My pride will range any time.
My youngest son, Sebastian, I leave Tom, the family cat. This small bequest that I know he is capable of making his own way in the world without my help.
Never mind, Tom. We'll stick together through thick and thin.
Is there no mention of any trinkets he may have had stashed away?
Oh yes, there's a note at the bottom here. To Dora Tettle, district nurse and spinster in this parish, I leave...
Yes, yes!
The remains of my rheumatism, girls. I leave my more pleasant home at your old age.
Is that all?
I'm afraid so.
Why, the mean old devil! And Sebastian, with only a cat for consolation. It's not fair!
I don't mind, Dora. I can always work for my brother, if you'll have me.
Of course, both you and Sidney can work for me. At a reduced wage.
Reduced wage? But we barely got enough from father as it was. We can't live on less.
That's my offer, take it or leave it.
Mr. Testament, is he allowed to do this?
I'm afraid there's nothing in your father's will to stop him. Now, you must excuse me. I have a case of grand larceny back at the office.
Is that Anthony Knight here, Maria?
Good night, Mr. Testament. Thank you for the good news.
Goodbye, Mr. Wilson. Remember, if you need it or divorce, I'm your man. I'll be sending my bill later. Bye-bye.
Well, what are you not standing around for? Haven't you got homes to go to? And you two, get back to your jobs. If you're going to work for me, there'll be no snapping.
You're a slave driver, Silas Millstone. I wouldn't be married to you if you were the last man on earth.
If I were the last man on earth, you'd have to wait your turn in the queue. Yeah. Now, get back to the surgery before I lose my temper.
Don't worry, I'm off. Ta-ta, lads. It must be terrible to have a millstone around your necks.
Did you mean what you said about reducing our wages?
Of course. From now on, you only get half the wage that father pays you.
In that case, I'm handing in my notice. I'll work until the end of the week and then look for employment elsewhere.
Do I only get half my wage as well?
Of course not, Sidney.
Oh, goody, goody, gilderoats!
No, you only get a quarter of what father paid you.
What? Then I'm leaving as well. United we stand.
Any lying you fool. Very well, leave me. See if I care. If you don't want the job, there are plenty on the dole to do.
Come on, Sidney. Let's get back to work. There is a bag of flour to load up.
Yes, remember your word. those bands loaded by tonight, or you'll get no wages.
Oh, you're right. I've lost my job, and I'm orphaned as well.
Oh, don't upset yourself. We'll manage.
I'm just a poor little orphan.
Have you ever felt like this before?
Yes, orphan.
Come on, let's get on with the job.
Yeah, we can look for work tonight. Well, here, there, look for a good bargain down with the bell.
Oh, thanks for good customers.
Thank you.
please, Sebastian. Don't cry down to me. I'm still the same Angelina that you met a few moments ago.
Now I understand why you are so beautifully dressed. And why you say we cannot meet again.
Oh dear, if only things were different.
If I were rich, would there be a chance for me?
Well, that would depend upon my father, the king. I think it would stand more of a chance if you were a duke or a marquis. I'm afraid my father's pretty stout.
Your water, Your Highness!
Thank you, Valdo.
My training him for the dark!
And what would you say if I asked you to be my boyfriend?
Nay!
But don't you like it just a little bit?
Nay!
Come along, Valdo. It's time we were on our way and left these good people to their neighbours.
Stay, just a little bit.
Oh, very well. Valdo, make sure the coachman is ready to leave.
Very well, Your Highness. Hi-ho! Silver! Just in to talk to Tom. He'll know the assignment.
right there.
I can see it's not only Silas that's the lucky man.
Oh, there you are, Sebastian! Good gracious! It's D'Artagnan!
Don't you recognize him? It's Tom, my hat!
Why is he dressed up in all those fine clothes? Is he going to a fancy dress party?
No, it's done by magic!
Listen to that!
Said what?
Trinity's fellow! Did you hear it?
Yes, of course I did.
I really can't talk here.
There it is again! But there's only a cat there!
Yes, it was Tom that spoke.
You're having me on! Cats can't talk, can they?
Oh, yes, they can!
Oh, no, they can't!
Oh, yes, they can!
Oh, no, they can't!
Oh, yes, they can!
Do not fear or show alarm, for I am your servant, Mom.
It's all right. He's not going to harm you.
By Jove! It's a poetic pussy! Is it done by computer?
No. I was visited by the fairy it was brought to.
You don't mean Larry Grayson!
No. This was a real fairy, and she's made Tom clever and brave.
You are lucky. Did you think a fairy would come and visit me?
If she did, what would you ask for?
The same thing I ask for in my prayers every night.
And what's that?
It's very simple. I just kneel by my bedside with my hands together in prayer and say, Amen. Amen.
Never mind. I'm sure someone will turn up someday.
Yes, I do hope so. Because I'm long past my first flush. And it takes a cistern some time to fill up these days.
Cheer up, Dora. I've got a feeling that my friends will improve from now on. What do you say, Tom?
I know it is, Master. And I'll be the one to do it.
Thank you.
was only this morning. But you can give me some milk.
Well, you can give milk, but I've got that from the cow.
That's what I meant, your Wally. I've got an antenatal clinic in half an hour, and this week's lesson is how to feed the new baby.
And you've come just at the right time. I'm going to milk Clara.
He told me he didn't have it tomorrow.
Oh,
have in mind.
It's a lovely spot, Tom. But I can't understand why you wanted me to come here.
It's the first step in making your fortune.
But how can a riverbank doctor make my fortune?
Take off your jacket and go for a swim in the river.
Will that make me rich?
Just trust me. You'll be surprised.
Very well. Nothing ventured, nothing gained.
Soon get used to it. That's the last time my master will see those old rags. Now get rid of these hornets. Just in time. The royal coach is stopping. My master, the Marquis of Carabas, decided to go for a swim in the river. Whilst he was in the water, robbers came along. They stole his clothes and then drove off in his carriage.
What was that about? Marriage?
Not marriage, my dear. Carriage.
Pardon?
Carriage. Carriage!
All right, don't shout. I can hear perfectly well.
You're as deaf as a post.
Rich silks, brocades, and his shoes have just come back from the cobblers.
What did he say?
The cobblers.
Pardon?
Cobblers!
There's no need to be rude.
Your master. My master would be eternally grateful if you could help him out of this predicament, for I fear without your help, he may get lost.
What did he say?
He said he may get lost.
Pardon?
Get lost!
As for my master. May I borrow your cloak, Your Highness?
Certainly, my lord.
Thank you, thank you, sir. Fear not, your lordship. Help is at hand.
What a wonderful swim.
I'm pleased your lordship enjoyed it, but I regret to tell you that whilst you were in the water, your clothes were stolen.
Oh, no! What are we going to do?
Don't worry. The king and queen happened to stop by. I'm sure they'll help us.
Your Majesties.
May I introduce my master, the Marquis of Carabas?
He seems like a nice boy. What do you say, my dear?
Yes, I think it might rain again.
I said he seems like a nice boy.
Pardon?
He seems like a nice boy.
He seems like a nice boy.
I just said that. So you're the Marquis of Carabas.
I mean, I am.
Well, you must come back with us to the palace. I'm sure I've got the odd suit of clothes you can borrow.
Your Majesty is most kind.
And we'll have a small celebration. It'll give us the ideal opportunity to introduce you to our daughter, the Princess Angelina.
The Princess Angelina?
Yes. I despair of her ever meeting the right man, if she's so choosy.
It will be a real pleasure.
I've just had a thought.
Yes, what's that, my dear?
Introduce him to our daughter, the Princess Angelina.
I just said that. You think you'll train her in for the later model, you know. Now come along, young man. My coach is just over there.
Your Majesty is very kind.
I shall travel to the castle and arrange for your servants to go to the palace to attend your every need. Yes, your old manservant and your personal cook.
Come along, young man, we haven't got all day.
Very good, Your Majesty.
Carabas.
But the Marquis of Carabas? There isn't such a person.
Oh, there is now. And you two are his servants.
What do you mean?
Would you like to travel to the palace?
Oh, we'd love to, wouldn't we, Sydney?
Oh, yes. Then you can be his manservant.
And what's that mean?
You can be his vegetable cook.
Oh, good. I can try out one of my new recipes. Like roasted ferret in toast or sauce, or marinated frog's legs in prune juice.
But what about clones? You can't go to the palace dressed like this.
Oh, that's true. We'll have to get the people out there to help call for the Fairy of Good Fortune.
How do we do that?
We get them to say a little rhyme.
We say?
We say, Fairy, Fairy, hear our prayer, bring us lots of clothes to wear.
That's easy, isn't it?
Very easy. Now come on, you lot. This is your turn. You want a little bit of help to call the Fairy of Good Fortune? Up to three. One, two, three.
Fairy, Fairy!
Well, that wasn't very good, was it?
Was it?
Could you make it?
No, was it? Was it shouting?
No, I don't think so. Let's try it one more time. We'll have a little bit of audience participation this time, please. Right, nice and loud, the Fairy of Good Fortune. You look down here and rely on you, okay? After three. One, two, three.
The band weren't shouting either.
What band? Oh, that band. I think you're right. I think we should get those people joining as well. And don't forget one on the end on the drums. Making noise all night long. The way you want to be them, never go. Right, all together. Band with us. Ready?
Fairy.
After three.
You'll pick it up as we go.
One, two, three.
Thank you. he would turn up at the palace. He might bring his brother with him.
You were very keen on him, weren't you?
Keen? I think he's the sexiest thing since Jason Donovan.
Then let's face it, we're both in the same boat. We have about as much chance of getting our men as Nigel Lawson of becoming Prime Minister.
I've just heard your father is to entertain a marquis tonight. Who knows, he might turn out to be as handsome as Sebastian.
You'll be telling me next you've probably got a servant that looks like Sydney.
That's better. It's the first time I've seen you happy since you left that room with her.
It's no joke. I'm only fooling myself. I won't really be happy until I see Sebastian again.
And I won't be happy until I see Sydney again.
Shut up!
about that pretty yellow frock. But I'll have to do the bell tap.
What did you say?
I'll have to do the bell tap.
What?
The bell tap.
That does it. I don't have to stay here to be insulted. I shall go to my room and try on that pretty yellow frock. But you'll have to do the bell tap for me.
Well, what are you lot standing around for? Well, in a party tonight, we must look our best. Hey, run along and start yourselves up. We have the Marquess of Carabas staying with us for the weekend. And we must show him what all the wonderful people we all are. Now, run along. Run along, will you? Oh, you can't get the staff nowadays. Not since they have great bills, as well. Better. Bring on the royal bowl of water.
Bring on the royal bowl of water.
Bring on the royal bowl of water.
And don't forget the radars.
And don't forget the radars.
Don't forget the radars.
It's not all fun being a king, you know. These royal walkabouts can play havoc with your feet. Sometimes people throw eggs at you and all sorts of strange things. It can be most undignified.
Good day, Your Majesty. I bought you a bowl of water so that you can wash the royal tootsies.
It doesn't look very clean to me.
It's your flagship. All water in that bowl has been passed personally by the Lord Chamberlain.
You're a London-pleasing person. What's your name?
I am Miss Dorodettle. Chef. To his chip shop, the Marquess of Carabas.
Well, come and sit beside me and see what we can cook up together.
Your Highness, this is less cup.
Now, what do you fancy for starters?
I beg your
pardon. For tonight's banquet.
Oh, I see. Well, if I was preparing a meal, I would start with honeymoon salad.
Honeymoon salad? What's that?
Well, it's tomato alone.
Tomato alone?
It's cucumber alone.
Cucumber alone?
I remember now, it's lettuce alone. You get it? Lettuce alone. How do you remember? And followed by politician's pie.
Politician's pie? What's that?
Well, it's like pork pie, but it's filled with chives and hot air.
And what about something to drink?
And the whole lot should be washed down with an amusing, not to say hilarious, bottle of Deeply Down Down Chateau Neuf 85.
Well, I'll leave it to you. You seem to know your business.
But I am.
You're a chef, aren't you?
Yes, but...
Then it's settled. Just call up for the ingredients.
How many am I catering for?
Oh, not many. About 250.
250?
Yes, it's just a small affair. Anything will do. Caviar, olive oil roast venison, or a few fresh oysters wrapped up with turkey and champagne. Nothing special at all.
Do I open my big mouth? Now, who's that little Sydney? Sydney! Bring on the special portable kitchen! Good idea. Bring on the ingredients.
Right away, keep you.
He may be a wally, but he's a lovely brother, really.
Here we are, self-raising flour.
Pour it in the bowl, my precious. And now we need some milk.
Milk coming up.
We should be demonstrating this on the telly, man. Much here for 250.
50. Still, I expect a little rise in the oven.
Here we are. Fortunately, it's hard boiled.
Right, now for a little magic with a wooden spoon.
We bet you're good at that.
What makes you say that's my heartthrob?
Everybody in the village says you're the biggest stirrer around.
Treating that remark with the contempt it deserves, I shall continue with my culinary masterpiece. Eat your heart out, Egon Romaine!
Sebastian!
Do you know the Marquis of Carabas, my dear?
fault in you lot. You look like you've lost a £5 note and found a penny. I'm the only one that's supposed to look miserable in this show.
Things aren't the same around here anymore.
Why not? Nothing has changed since last week.
Yes, it has. Slaffin and Sydney have gone off to seek their fortunes
near Paper Door
and Daniel
Winston. Good riddance, I say. If they weren't prepared to work for the wages I offered, then it's best they go and look for other jobs.
But what happens if someone in the village needs a nurse? Mrs. Jones is expecting a baby next week.
Then you'll have to get the security ball man in.
The security ball man?
Yes, he's the only one that makes regular deliveries around here.
You're to blame for this, Anthony, also.
Me? I don't even know Mrs. Jones.
You know what I mean. You have treated your brother so badly that he'd still be here.
Rubbish. I'm a very good employer. In fact, I'm looking for a couple of workers to help me run the mill. What do you say?
That's my age, you must be joking.
Now, there's no sexual discrimination here. I'll take anybody.
We'd get more money on the toe.
Of all the ungrateful people, you don't take the biscuit.
Your wage would have torn the biscuit.
Then be off with you and go and bother someone else.
Let's go to the King's Palace. There's a rumour going round that Sebastian's gone there.
Oh, yes. To marry the King's daughter, I suppose.
Things have happened.
I'll tell you this, and you mark my words. The day that Sebastian marries a princess, I will personally give him half my inheritance.
He'll
be lucky if he gets a job in the palace kitchens. It's common knowledge that the king will only choose a nobleman for his future son-in-law.
The king has been known to change his mind.
If you lot worked as hard as you talked, we'd be the richest village in the country. Now get off my land before I lose my temper. Go on before I lose my temper. They must think I'm mad. Sebastian married a princess indeed. It's ridiculous. Anyway, this won't do. It's no fun doing the work of three men. I've got plenty more to do.
I say, my man!
Yes, my lady? May I be of assistance?
I'm quite fatigued by my journey. Bring me something I can put on which I can rest myself.
Right away, my lady.
Ha-ha! You didn't recognise me. This could be fun.
Pray be seated, my lady.
Most kind. It is such a long way from the Royal Palace.
The Royal Palace? Have you travelled from the Royal Palace?
Oh, yes, indeed. We had such a party last night. The wine didn't flow like dishwater.
I wonder why they make so long.
Please, sir, not here. Someone might see us.
Then no, you misunderstand.
Oh, dear, that's pretty.
Does the name Sebastian mean anything to you?
Sebastian, now let me see. What does he look like?
Well, he's a tall, fair, quite good-looking, and a bit like me, in fact.
Oh, you must be the Marquis of Carabas. I believe his name is Sebastian.
No, I mean my brother.
Oh, dear me, no. Oh, no, the Marquis is a most cultured gentleman. Not a common peasant like what you are.
Thank goodness for that. I knew the villagers must be mistaken. After all, there must be lots of Sebastians about. If you'll excuse me, I have some flowers to write.
It will be an enormous pleasure to excuse you.
You're most kind.
Ha-ha! Serves the old Bulkman right. I think it's never worked so hard in his life. It is nice to be home, you know. Palace is all right, but they don't compare with the countryside. Oh, well. I may have got my own back on that Silas Millstone, but that doesn't help. Sebastian, when the king finds out he's not a real marquis, he'll never let him marry his daughter.
After all that walking, you think the king could have left his carriage or summer?
Where's Tom?
We'll be here soon. He's a peasant for dinner.
Don't be silly, the council never makes as much noise as that.
mask at Halloween.
Now stop arguing, you two.
They've broke and sail off the windmill.
Ooh. Silas won't be able to grind his flour.
What are we going to do?
We'll get the people out here to call for the fairy of good fortune.
How do we do that?
Well, we say it in a little while.
This is a rhyme, girl.
It goes, fairy, fairy, from the blue, come and tell us what to do.
That's easy, isn't it?
Will you help us?
Does that mean only some of you will help us? That's more like it. After three, one, two, three. Not very good on this, are they?
They're not!
You have all the napkins and all
that. Yeah, much though. Yes. Quite again.
We'll try them again. After three now. Little bit louder. Help from the band and David Bailey. Right? One, two, three.
Bye.
news first or the bad news?
Tell us the good news first.
There is a castle in the mountain.
Wonderful! What's the bad news?
one.
What's that?
I'm scared!
Just think! That long journey will be waiting for you to return to the palace victorious, to throw her arms around you and give you a big, big kiss.
That's decided it. I walk back in the middle.
Thank you.
searching the grounds and the outbuildings.
Good, I'll go and help them.
Oh, no, you don't.
I can't understand it. There's no spike and die at all.
Do you think he might be upstairs?
Let's go and see. Sydney, you stay here with Dora. If you hear him coming, shout for help.
I'll shout so loud to lead you down Castle Coop.
So will I. I like a man to be big, but even I can't climb the giant.
Come along then, Tom. We must dispose of the giant before the king and queen arrive. Keep your sword handy, Sydney.
Don't have to use it, do I?
Yes, if the need arises.
Can't I just fight him a bit?
I suppose we could always kick him in the shins at Belsen, screaming from his own castle.
Where's your stick up in it?
Above his chattering teeth!
Never mind. I'll look after him. After all, they used to change his nappies.
Did you really?
Yes, in fact, I still do from time to time.
You dare,
everybody! I think
money. And with the money collected from the villages, you'll never have to wear the game.
Come along, let's get things coming up.
Thank you.
to buy new ones. My brothers have left me, and no one else is willing to help me run the mill. You two have come back, I see. Well, Sydney, you can have your old job back if you want. I'm not one to bear grudges.
I think you are hearing the good news first.
Go on then, I'm in need of cheering up.
Sebastian has killed the giant and is going to marry the king's daughter.
What?
Yeah, and you've been invited to the wedding.
Sebastian and the Princess Angelina?
Yes, so that means you give them half of your inheritance, doesn't it?
But I didn't really mean it.
It's too late to get out of it now, and besides, all these good people were witnesses.
Surely. Surely, if he's to marry a princess, he won't need half of my inheritance.
That's right, Louise. Very kindly said that I can have it.
You're welcome. I haven't even enough money to buy new sails.
Don't worry, my share of what the village was connected should be enough.
You and I can become partners, Sydney.
And I hope you've learned your lesson, Silas Millstone.
I have. I promise I'll never be wrong to anybody ever again.
That's what we like to hear. And like all good pantomimes, we're all going to live happily ever after. Now, come on, you can't go to your wedding like that. You can't go in your working clothes. Whatever would the king say?
I'll go at once. See you later, partner.
Okay, then. Shall we go and get our Briscoes on the 12th?
Can't do that yet.
Why not?
From the community song,
yeah? Oh, yes, I was forgetting. Listen to the words then.
Show you the actions. Right, object. think you're hungry.
Rubbish! They did it today.
Thank you.
I got that one.